up, guys? So, day 3 of the wire management build. Brought some tubing from Amazon to try to, like, you know, secure most of the wires. I did do the amps and the processor. I did wire them up. And also I bought some of these not zip ties, Velcro straps, which makes it a lot more easier when it has this ring on it so I can loop it. Pretty neat, actually. I'm gonna tube up the speaker wire soon. I already cut them down to size, they're all the same length, which leads to the amplifier one. When I push it back closer to the wall, it's more than enough length. Before, the length was like super long, I had to wrap it up in balls. The processor, everything is wrapped up nice and neat. This is for the next amp that's coming in, and all that is hooked up. Same over here for these speakers. Cut to length. And here's the amplifier. So, coming along slowly. Still not nowhere near done. Still got a whole bunch of stuff all over the place. But, yeah, guys. It's a lot of work, man. It's a lot of work. But at the end of the road, end of the day, I guess it'll be worth it. Alright, so I'm gonna tube up the speaker wires and be right back. So here's the finished product of the speaker wires. These are all the surrounds, not the mains yet. I left the Velcro straps a different color, so if I do have to peek behind here for something, I know that the speakers are in the gray Velcro and the XLRs. I'm planning on doing the HDMIs black too, or maybe gray. I don't know yet, but the speakers all Velcroed up. So next one will be the HDMIs, and I also have the Ethernet cords cables to do also, and other miscellaneous stuff like adapters and chargers for different stuff, or power cords from different stuff. Oh, but the real problem will probably have to be the power cords, because these things are like friggin' heavy and thick. So that'll probably be the issue. It's getting there slowly, but it ain't easy. So I finally did the Ethernet cords coming from the router over there. I'm not sure what I really want to like do with these, with this end. It might have to show, but the rest of it is sealed up. I'm kind of basically done. I still got the power wires to put in, but I use that for last. And I'm just waiting on a new amp to come before I start hooking up the speaker wires. Mini DSP is hooked up. I wish it had like some kind of keyhole on the back of it somehow, so I can like maybe like paste it on the wall or screw it on the wall or something like that. But I don't know. But yeah, I'm pretty much coming to the finish line. Besides waiting on the amp, I think the only thing that's holding me back right now is the amp, because I want to just put it in and hook it up, and then I get to push stuff back, and you know. Oh, besides the little miscellaneous things like the power cords and stuff like that for the LEDs, that's probably gonna be like a little annoying, because it's so like thin wires and stuff, just thin wires. So I don't know if I might tuck those under the stand or whatever, but that's the update so far. And so this is basically the finished product. I would say maybe 99%. It may still look crazy, but it's not a rack, so everything is horizontal. So I don't have enough space to, you know, make everything super neat, but I tried my best. Stuff like the HDMIs and the Ethernet cords, they're like over 3 feet. They're like 6 and 10 or whatever. Because, you know, I don't want to rebuy them when I do move out of this place. So I kind of future-proofed myself and got pretty long cords. But the best I can do is like wrap them up like that with some Velcro straps, just to try to get out the way. But it's much neater than how it was before. The only thing I really have to do now is connect all the Ethernet cords to all the devices, and of course the power cords. I'm trying to like make it a little bit neat and stuff it under the stand, but that's basically it. Everything, this is kind of like the best I can do with the space that I have. So I'm gonna connect the power cords and the Ethernets, and I'll show you guys the 100% finished product. So this is the best I can do. All the power cords are connected. Everything is connected. Only thing left to do now is to push the stand back closer to the wall how it was before. And the only issue I have is this thing right here, which is my fans. It can't really go under the table once I push it back, so it's going to be sticking out a little bit with the excessive amount of rolled up cord right there. Nothing else I can do, but like I said, everything else is like 6 feet long, and this is a horizontal stand, so I don't have much room, but it's way more organized than it was prior to it being like this. So one more video to shoot, and that's how everything looks completely. So let me push back the stand and see you guys in a little bit. So everything is back to normal. Everything is hooked up again. That can't be helped, but I do have a peace of mind knowing that everything is, you know, organized. Nothing is going to be loose. Everything is secure. That's just a peace of mind. But in terms of being super neat, it's physically impossible on a TV stand that's horizontal. You need a rack to be more organized than this. But like I said, it's peace of mind. Everything is good. Everything is measured up correctly. Only thing I have to do now for myself is do a test tone, make sure everything is working, everything's plugged in. But it is though, because if it wasn't, the amps would have been showing red or something like that. So I think I'm okay. So thank you guys for this journey. Is it possible to make a super neat wire management with a horizontal TV stand? The answer is no. It's impossible. But you can make yourself, you know, happy that you did it and everything is secure. But in terms of beauty, it's not gonna win any beauty awards. So again, thank you guys for you know, being with me with this journey, and hope you guys like it. Alright. Peace.